13 years ago, at the age of 17, our son Paul acquired a severe brain injury. He wasn't expected to survive, but he chose to live. His injuries were too severe for him to qualify for rehabilitation. We were told we were delusional to bring him home, that he belonged in a nursing home. The decision to bring Paul home was the right choice for us. Having a purpose helps me make sense of what's happened to our family. I knew sharing our story had the power to help bring about change, and I'd been speaking out long before the National Disability Insurance Scheme was proposed. But with the NDIS came the promise to give people with disability and their families the chances and choices that we all take for granted. The opportunity for people with disability to live the best life they can. The NDIS promised support not only now, but into the future, even beyond our time with Paul. I had a new and very clear focus. I was then and remain now 1,000% committed to the full implementation of the NDIS. I encourage you to dare to dream for your loved one and your family, but to temper those dreams with realism. Prepare yourself by attending information sessions. Familiarise yourself with the NDIA website and learn the lingo. Early in our journey, I experienced the cavernous gap between the compensable and non-compensable systems in the world of disability. What excites and motivates me is that when the NDIS is fully implemented, other families will not have to go through what we've been through. We live in an NDIS trials site. This is a new world for everyone, including participants, planners, families, therapists and service providers. There are going to be mistakes and lessons learned. We are all in this together. I believe this disability reform is the best thing Australia has ever seen, and I take the responsibility of living in a trials site seriously. We are in a unique position to help shape how the NDIS will roll out across Australia. I've been inundated with questions from people who live in the universe parallel to ours, those waiting for the NDIS to reach them. People are hungry for knowledge. For us, although it's been a bumpy implementation, the NDIS is evolving and it had to have a starting point. My hope is that the journey will be less bumpy for those who follow us. A clear understanding of your current funding. Surround yourself with supporters and consider finding yourself a knowledgeable advocate. Foster a partnership with the NDIA. Mutual respect is tremendously beneficial. Make use of the NDIA review processes. Naively, I thought our first encounter with the NDIS would mean a light review of Paul's current state-funded plan. Nothing could have been further from the truth. It had taken us 11 and a half years to get to the point where we were able to go to bed at night with some measure of peace. We finally had the supports in place to enable Paul and ourselves to get back to living life. That was all it was ever about for us. All that we'd learned, the years of blood, sweat and tears that had gone into Paul's plan, had fallen by the wayside. It was heartbreaking. We had to begin the process of rebuilding his plan brick by brick. Although it's taken 9 months, Paul's first NDIS plan is almost finalised. We've been fortunate to have the support and backing of a strong and knowledgeable team and advocate. We've moved mountains this year. I feel really proud of what we've achieved to date. We're in a better place now than we were prior to the NDIS. My commitment to the NDIS is unwavering. But for me, the battle won't be over until the NDIS is a reality for all Australians with a disability. My dream for the future is that when these parallel universes do merge, many of the lessons will have been learned and mistakes ironed out. I hope those coming over to the NDIS universe experience a smooth journey. And don't be afraid to keep questioning until you're satisfied with the results. Ensure you and your service providers thoroughly understand your plan. The message I'd really like to get across is not to feel scared of the future. Embrace what you need to do to achieve the very best outcomes. If you do get a plan you're not happy with, have the courage to hand it back. Regard it as a work in progress, it doesn't happen straight away. We're all in this new world together, and to achieve the best outcomes, we need to have mutual respect, patience, and the courage to follow our dreams. Paul's about to have his first much anticipated holiday with us, his brother, sister, nieces and nephews. We could never have imagined getting to this point. We're now able to start dreaming and planning as a family again.